Hey, and welcome to part two of Solørbanen. Thanks for joining. I am the Norwegian train driver, and we are approaching our first station. Well, first, we had one station in last part on kilometer 33, but that's no longer in use, so I don't count that one. So the first one coming up in a few kilometers are Flisa. And the second one is Braskereidfoss. And Braskereidfoss lies in my municipality, so it was a short trip for me to make some cool drone footage. Unfortunately, none of the stations were manned on this trip, but I have one trip here from the opposite direction in editing now where both stations were manned, so I hope to show that to you soon. So this line don't have any remote control abilities, so the station masters turn on the signal when they come to work at the station, and they have to control the switch themselves. And they have to show us a flag if we are going to stop or not. So this is really old school train driving. I mentioned a couple of signal poles in a previous video of mine. Here is another one. This one. This sends a signal to the road barrier to lower the barriers. So when you see one of those on the right side, you know it's a road barrier coming up. This V on the right side is also to tell us there's a road barrier coming up. So this pole to the left of us, if four trains are in the other direction, to lower the barriers on the previous road barrier we just left. So we see a flashing white light. That means that barriers are down. There's usually a pre-signal for them, but this is a long straight line here, so they didn't feel it was necessary to put up a pre-signal for it. So the signal for the station is coming up here, and as you see, it's a much simpler signal than we are used to. So this is turned off now, but if there was a manned station and the station master was there, then he would have a green or red light for us here. And the round sign with the number 2 in it, that's this switch coming up here. You can only have 20 kilometers per hour. There is a giant toothpick here on the left side. So I worked at this factory some years ago for several years. They made toothbrushes and such there. But since the station is unmanned now, we can have the normal velocity through it, and that's 60. If it was manned, then we have to have 40. And if we have to go through the switch, then we have to have 20. So the station master must call us and say we are going through the switch so we know what speed to have. So here you see the black and white pole again, and when it's in a station, it's got a different meaning. It's more like a stop sign now, because if you are meeting another train here, you have to stop before this pole so the other train can pass you on the track to the right. There's a hoarder coming up on our left side here. I like to hoard inside the house, but he's got a different opinion. municipality. The border is around here. Voller station to our left here. Two of my neighbors are coming up on the left side here, so let's honk for them. So I have a drone clip I would like to show you, where my colleague passed here in the exact same locomotive. I went out with my drone and captured this. So the house to the right here are some really renovation phantoms. The scaffolding has been here since I started in Hector Ale, like 3 years. They'll never finish.
So the 1 kilometer distance marker is coming up on our right side here. And on lines without remote control, there is also this signal to the right here. It's the distance sign 2, that means it's 800 meters to the signal. There's also a timber terminal to the right of us here. It's a huge industrial area here. We also fill wagons with wood chips here in the winter time. That goes to Stockholm for central heat. I have a drone clip from when those wood chips wagon were standing here, so I'll show you that. Alright, flying with the drone in the opposite direction now. So the tracks to our left here leads both to the timber terminal and to the wood chip loading. So this was filmed during a rescue mission. You see there is two locomotives here, and the second one had a breakdown. So I had to rescue it with a locomotive that's the first one. So the second locomotive, it was for repairs for mountains. Station now. You see there is no light in the signal, so no light, no station master, so we can just continue on normal speed. So the municipality border is here, so we are leaving Våler now and entering into Elverum municipality. So the field to our left here is fairly new. There was a forest here 2 years ago. There was a lot of machines working here, and now it's a field with a fancy watering system, as you see up ahead here.
So Solørbanen is famous to be very slippery in the autumn when the leaves fall from the trees and onto the tracks, and when the wheels of the train and wagons grind the leaves, they release some oily substance that is very slippery. And you see, we are almost driving into a tunnel of trees here, so yep, there's a lot of problem in the autumn. So, welcome to Vestmo Timber Terminal. You made it all through Solørbanen now, and now I have to call the station master to get him to release the locks so I can get the key to the switches here. I have to operate them myself. So this timber terminal lies within the borders of the station, so the station master controls this area. So to recap, we are here, and the station is up here. And the two bridges we crossed, they are down here. Okay, you guys hang out here while I go out in the rain and remove the train barrier over here. Get the key to the switch. Thanks for waiting. Let's head into the terminal. So the loaders are ready here to give us some timber. They use some modified wheel loaders here. Thank you. So one of the loaders texted me and told me where to stop, and he want me to stop just before the switch in the middle of the terminal here. So we're gonna stop there. I'm gonna detach the locomotive, then I'm gonna go further north and go around on the track to the left of us here and place the locomotive on the other end of the wagons, so they are in the right position when we are going back home. So here you see the train barrier on the track to the right. So I have to get the key to remove that, then go and operate the switch and drive past the switch and operate again and move back on the track to the left here. Alright, I'll go out and operate the switch now, and I'm gonna drive from the opposite side. So you just stay put here. Okay, so I'm gonna skip through this switch crap now. I guess you've seen enough. I'll round up this part two with a drone capture I did in a much better weather, so you'll see it from an aerial view. Alright, I hope you enjoyed Solørbanen as much as I did, and we will revisit Solørbanen in a later video. If you got any questions or comment, please ask and comment. So I hope you join me in my next video. Until then, have a good one and see ya.